Welcome, this is Plant Smart Living with Farmer Fred. I'm glad you could join me today. Today I wanted to read words of encouragement from a friend. She wrote these essays, and you know, these essays are for people that are either transitioning to a whole food plant-based lifestyle or for those that are following this type of lifestyle. So anyhow, today's essay is called The Road From There to Here. You know, from my own personal experience with friends and family and loved ones, you know, following this type of lifestyle, you know, it's the world out there is anti-health, and you know, even spouses or family members or even the medical system is really against this type of lifestyle. And so I know for me these words of encouragement have been very helpful just to encourage me and to stay on this path. And So anyhow, the title from this essay is called The Road From There to Here. The road from where I have been to where I am now was long and wide. There were paths and byways off to each side which led in many different directions. There were trails which would have taken me far from here. There were so many ways for me to have gone wrong. Good old-fashioned fear catapulted me on to the long, wide road towards health, and good old-fashioned fear made sure that I would remain on it. Otherwise, I might have veered off course onto some popular mass-marketed avenue or exciting shortcut. I might have found myself mired in fads and gimmicks, pills and promises, high-fat paths leading to weight loss accompanied by kidney failure, high-tech surgeries and bands and staples, leading to health by way of mutilation. I didn't go down those roads. I stayed on the road less traveled, the road which ran parallel to nature and good common sense. There were no secrets for sale at just the right place on this road. No sleights of hand, no enticing shortcuts, no breakthrough inventions promising me that I could have my cake and eat it too. There was only the second by second, hour by hour, sometimes walking, sometimes crawling, forever movement in one singular direction down the straightforward road, accompanied only by the hope that nature would guide me and that the bounty of her gifts could save me. I took it slow. I took it steady. I would glance over at the well-worn paths on either side of me and, with every step, affirm to myself that I would not be distracted by scintillating claims of miracle cures and magic pills invented by the test tube genius of modern man. I walked down the road from there to here, guided by nature alone. I walked with slow, deliberate paths, steps, with no end in sight and no guarantee that I would ever get there. I walked forward and did not look back. I only knew too well what lay behind me. The steps became the journey. Signs would appear before me, the unmistakable signs of long-forgotten health which told me that I was on the right track. It no longer became important to reach the end point because the journey itself became an adventure and a delight. I knew that this road, wide and spread out before me like a green beckoning pasture, would lead me back to where I belonged. The road was there and I followed it to here. It stretches before me now into a strong and healthy future, but it is narrowed down into one straight and single lane which I follow steadfastly until I reach its end. There are no other paths to take or avenues to explore. This is the only way for me. Nature herself laid down this road, and as far as I can tell, no man has improved upon it. Let others go from here to there in search of their own direction, their own signs and signals, their own goalposts and shortcuts. Let others follow down roads which lead to man-made solutions, restriction and sacrifice, guilt and deprivation. The road from there to here has brought me back to life I was meant to lead. It showed me the world as it was meant to be. It led me away from a place I should never have visited and back to a place I should never have left. Others may preach as they choose and do as they wish. I have found my way. Love, Lori. Well, anyhow, I hope these words of encouragement have been helpful to you. So until next time, this is Plant Smart Living with Farmer Fred.